Good morning, I'm Rini Gupta, your tech host. Welcome to the Daily Tech News Bulletin. In today's tech news, Google Essential is a new Windows app coming first in HPZ. India, FinTech phone pay launches created use on app. Zomato shuts down intercity region services with an immediate effect. Android 15 QPR1 Beta 1 is live for Pixel. Hints at longer Pixel 6 support. Google launches AI chatbot to help YouTube channel creators recover hacked account. Airtel Payments Bank launches to face match to secure customer accounts with a selfie verification. Snap is reportedly working on a new pair of augmented reality spectacles. In yesterday's quiz, we asked you what is the another words of application, and the answer is program. It's time for a daily tech quiz. Here's today's question. What is the full form of HP? Think you know the answer? We want to hear from you. Leave your guess in the comments below this video. We reveal the correct answer in tomorrow's news bulletin. So stay tuned. See you if you got it right. A new window app designed to help users discover and install Google services like Google Photos, Messages and Play Games on their PC. The app provides a centralized platform for accessing various Google apps and services, including Shortcut to Google Doc, Drive and Calendar, Quick Share, formerly Nearby Share, is part of the app, although not explicitly mentioned in Google Blog. User can play smartphones games on their Windows PC with the Google Play Games and sync progress between devices. Initially, Google Essentials will be available on all HP Windows consumer and gaming brands like Spectre, Envy, Pavilion, Omen and Victus. PhonePe now allows users to link their credit lines to the Unified Payments Interface on its platform for payment. User can make payments via credit line and UPI at millions of merchants across India. This feature follows the Reserve Bank of India's decision to include pre-approved credit lines within UPI. This is PhonePe's second major credit-related feature after the RuPay credit card and UPI. PhonePe aims to strengthen digital payments in India by providing innovative payments solutions in February. PhonePe launched the Indus App Store, offering over 2 lakh apps for games across 45 categories on 12 Indian languages. Zomato has shut down its intercity food delivery service Legions due to a lack of product market fit. This service, launched in August 2022, aimed to deliver a delicious from 10 cities across India to consumer homes. The service faced issue early on with the head of intercity delivery. Siddharth Jawar resigning in November 2022, Zomato quietly shut down Legions in April 2023 before relaunching it in July with new measures like minimum order value for ₹5,000. Despite effort, the service was permanently discontinued as of Thursday. Last month, Zomato also shut down its hyper-local delivery service Xtreme, which had been launched in October 2022. Google has started rolling out Android 15 QPR1 Beta 1 to Pixel device. QPR1 is a part of Google's quarterly update schedule, which follows a major OS releases with the QPR1 and QPR2 and QPR3 updates. QPR betas are more stable than developer previews and are often suitable for general use. The stable version of this update is expected to be released around December as a feature drop. To receive the QPR1 Beta 1 update, user must be enrolled in Google's Beta program. Existing Beta program members will automatically receive the update. New user can join by visiting Google website. Google has introduced an AI-powered chatbot to help YouTube creator recover hacked account. The chatbot assists creators in quickly regaining access to their account after a hack. The chatbot guides affected creators through securing their login and recovering their account. The chatbot asks a series of verification questions to confirm the identity of the channel owner. Creators can undo changes made by snackers and fully secure their channel. Initially, the AI chatbot is available only to a few creators in a select country. Payment Bank has launched a new security feature called Face Match to protect customers from fraud. The feature requires customers to take a selfie using the Airtel Thanks app, which is then a compared to the original account photo. Face match activate when the bank detects potentially risk actively in a customer's account. If the selfie matches the original photo, the transaction is approved. If not, the transaction is blocked. In case of mismatch, customer must visit a nearby bank branch for fingerprint verification. Face match is designed to prevent unauthorized access and protect account from auditors. Snap is working on a new pair of augmented reality spectacles, the fifth generation of their glasses. CEO Ivan Spiegel is expected to reveal the new AR glasses for Snap Partner Summit of September 17. Snap last AR glasses were introduced in 2021, but they were limited to a small group of creators and developers. The new spectacle will feature a wider field of view and a better battery life compared to the previous model. The latest glass will address some of the bulkiness and narrow field of view issues of earlier version. The new spectacles are likely to more focus on developers rather than general Snapchat users. This is Rindy Gupta signing off. Don't forget to stay tuned and subscribe to IT Voice for your all tech updates.